Good morning, folks. I don't really know what to make of this first story. A giant sturgeon kind of looks like a monster washed up on the east coast of the US. If you happen to know this is fake, please tell me. You may remember a few days ago I mentioned that there's a hazard off the UK coast. Apparently it's a methane released from an unexpected source. They were frantically evacuating personnel, and if you've been watching a while, you know that methane probably caused the greatest extinction in the history of Earth. If you're into this stuff, this is a great article on using lasers to protect Earth from asteroids. NASA loves getting my hopes up on the alien front. They're hoping to find organic material on Enceladus, little microbes in the water. The theory is that there could be a habitable sweet spot there. Many have asked about the 5-rocket trimethyl aluminum spray that NASA performed a few days ago from the Wallops Flight Center. Yes, folks, trimethyl aluminum reacts with oxygen to produce water and aluminum oxide, aka chemtrails. This is the sun a few days ago. Those dark spots are coronal holes which put out an energetic solar wind stream. That's what's causing this jump right here on the speed and the density you see here on the solar wind data from SOHO. It caused noticeable disturbances in the horizontal outer layer of the magnetosphere, along with some temporal variations here on the induction magnetometer. That's the strong resonance coming up from the 0 Hz line. Currently on the sun there are no critically dangerous regions, but down there you can see 11429 is set to return. You might remember this hell spot from early March gave us X flares, CMEs. Well, she survived her far side transit. There she is, right there in the center on stereo B with the Earth off to the right. You see here on the SDO, these bright regions turning on the bottom left, that is those here on the stereo B, so that big dog isn't far behind. As you watch the last 12 hours on the SDO, you can see on the top left some of those far side eruptions from that region and a few of the magnetic filaments that are facing Earth. It's going to be a big 2 weeks of solar activity, folks, starting tomorrow. That's the news. Be safe.